Years ago, Christmas Day meant heading over to my nan's, where it was always traditional to go for a Christmas walk in the evening to wish tidings of peace and goodwill to all that we met along the way, and more importantly, to burn off the Christmas dinner so we can make room for dessert. My nan was basically in charge of Christmas dinner, and year on year, this put a lot of pressure on her, and one year it was all too much. The strain was just too much for her to handle, and at the end of the walk, she suffered a heart attack. And it was just devastating. If there's one thing worse than fearing for the life of a close family member, it's fearing for the life of a close family member on Christmas Day. Most of the parents went on to hospital to stay with her, while all the cousins convened round ours to watch a seasonal Vicar of Dibley just to take our mind off things. Can't remember what year it was, I think it was about 7 or 8 years ago now, so, you know, a lot's happened since then, but she's been fighting fit since, and I really just can't stress how thankful I am for the doctors, nurses and paramedics that were there to help her on Christmas Day. That's when I realised Christmas, it's a magical day and all, but it's not immune to the problems that affect our everyday life. And for some, it's just another day at work. You can often forget there are some that put in really long hours to make it the best day for everyone possible. I mean, Christmas can be one of the most stressful, depressing times of the year, and there's even a part of me that's glad when it gets to January so that we can move on and look forward to the next one. I mean, the simple act of buying a present, that can be really fulfilling if you know what you're going to get, but if not, and you struggle, like so many people I know do, then, oh man, it just gets more stressful and stressful as the big day draws near. Say you're buying a toy plane, does it have to be a particular model, a particular colour? If you're buying for your other half, are you going to be bold enough to set a budget? And then you have that special family member that means so much to you, yet nothing springs to mind when you think of what to get them for Christmas. It doesn't take much for the anxiety just to bubble over and become hostile. This is my first Christmas working in retail, and believe me, there is nothing quite like it. You have about a dozen things to do, yet you can't walk more than 5 paces without a customer asking you where something is, or if an item that is definitely not in the back of the warehouse is in the back of the warehouse. And you have to go out and wander around looking for it, and you can't find it, and you get back to only tell them. And most of the time it's okay. Most of the time they're like, okay, that's fair enough, you know, we haven't got everything in stock, it's not a magic, big, endless place out there. But then there's other times when they just get so frustrated and it turns into an attack on you, and it's the last thing you need when you've got all these things to do. I don't want to be overly critical here, because customers, after all, are the life and blood source of retail. And Christmas is a time of year when many places, if they need it, you know, the rest of the year they're just about making ends meet. Christmas is a time of year where they go into the black and they make a profit. But at the same time, it's just those that respond so negatively that makes it 100 times worse. Also, the endless festive tunes on repeat do not help. I mean, I love Mariah Carey, but we never get the Mariah Carey version. There's about 100 different covers, which are never as good, aren't they? Never as good. You have to remember that Christmas doesn't happen without the scores of people who work hard over the festive period, like that postman who gets you your much-needed present on Christmas Eve on time, or those who work in bars and keep you feeling merry on Christmas Eve, or on New Year's Eve and New Year's Day. It isn't just about those who work over the festive period in the more traditional sense either. It's those who really put the effort in to make sure everything works out. I'm talking about the people in your life who make the Christmas season the best it can be. Those family and friends who really go all out. We have a big family party on Christmas Eve, and the reason it works so well is predominantly down to the hard work that my mum puts in. I mean, I help out as much as I can, but washing up and getting people drinks just doesn't compare to all the preparation she puts in for it. Then on the big day itself, my aunt hosts Christmas dinner for 14 of us, which is just a tremendous achievement. I don't know how she does it. So because of that, I'd like to raise a toast to those who work like hell over Christmas, because they really embody the spirit of the season. For them, Christmas is a frame of mind where you can't settle for less.
On the first day of Christmas, Zeppelin gave to me a video because I subscribed.